I have bought these 50 kilogram bathroom scale load cells and they come with the HX711 amplifier module. In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect the 50 kilogram load cells to the HX711 amplifier and how to read the weight values from it with an Arduino. I'm going to show you different possible connection diagrams. 4-cell circuit, 2-cell circuit, and a single-cell circuit. Theoretically, you could use an analog input of your microcontroller to read the weight directly from the load cells, but the voltage change inside the cell is so small that the sensitivity of the analog-to-digital converter inside Arduino isn't high enough to do that. That's why you need to use an amplifier. The working principle behind a load cell is that there are 4 resistors laid out in a diamond pattern. It's called a Wheatstone bridge. The circuit has 2 compression and tension resistor pairs. When you put some weight on the load cell, then the compression and tension resistors are going to change their values in the opposite direction. Now we can let current flow from top to bottom, and then measure the output voltage between the 2 remaining corners. If you apply force to the cell, then the resistance values start to change and you get the voltage difference that you can measure. With proper calibration, you can calculate the weight of the object on the cell. When no pressure is applied, then all the resistor values are equal and the measurement voltage is 0. A full Wheatstone bridge has 4 wires, but these 50 kilogram cells only have 3. These are only half bridges, but you can combine them to form a full bridge. You can connect 4 of them as a loop, you can connect 2 of them as a pair, or you can use a single one with 2 external resistors. I will go over all those scenarios one by one. But first, you should verify the wires with a multimeter. You need to find the middle wire. I have white, black and red. The resistance between white and black wires is 2 kilo-ohms. The resistance between the white and red wire is 1 kilo-ohm. And the resistance between black and red wire is also 1 kilo-ohm. This means that the red wire is the middle one. Let's start with the 4-cell loop diagram. This module doesn't have any screw holes, so I 3D printed these frames to mount them onto a wooden board. I will link my article about the load cells to the description box below. From there, you will also find the Thingiverse link to the mounting frame. Since black and white were the outer wires for me, I need to form a loop by connecting black to black and white to white. Now one diagonal will be the power wires that must be connected to the E plus and E minus outputs of the HX711 amplifier. And the other diagonal is to take measurements and must be connected to the A plus and A minus inputs of the amplifier module. You can validate the wiring with a multimeter. The diagonals should be about 2 kilo-ohms. The polarity here is irrelevant. Changing the power diagonal or switching polarity will just invert the calibration constant in the Arduino code. On the Arduino side, connect the VCC pin to the Arduino 5V pin and GND to the Arduino ground. Connect the amplifier's data pin to Arduino digital input pin 4 and clock pin to pin 5. Now download the HX711 ADC library. The link is in the description box below. Copy it to the Arduino libraries folder. Now you can open file, examples, HX711 ADC and calibration. If you used pin 4 and pin 5, then you can load this example to your Arduino without any modifications. Now let's open Arduino terminal. It asks for a known weight. iPhone 5 is 113 grams. It takes some time for it to settle back to zero. Now I will desolder the wires to demonstrate the two-cell circuit. The red middle wires will be the measurement wires and I will connect them to the A+ and A- inputs of the amplifier module. Now form a loop by connecting black to white and white to black. And now we need to power the cells from the connection points. So one white-black wire pair goes to E+ and the other one to E-. Now the resistance between the E+ and E- wire should be about 1 kilo ohm. And the resistance between A+ and A- wires should also be 1 kilo ohm. Now we need to recalibrate. This setup is not very accurate, since the other side of the scale is partly supporting my weight. To use only one cell, we need to use two external resistors to complete the Wheatstone bridge. I will use 1K resistors, since internally the load cell also has 1K resistors. I will power the cell from the white and black wires and measure between the red wire and the other end of the connected resistors. In this case also the resistance between the E+ and E- and A+ and A- should be about 1 kilo ohm. Let's recalibrate. This is very inaccurate, since a big part of my weight is supported by the other corners of the board. I also added a screen to make it look more like an actual scale. If you want to see more tutorials like this, then please leave a like and subscribe. Thank you for watching!